Our next speaker is someone who helped make today possible. And she not only helped make today possible by being an advocate and an attorney for many people who have become citizens in the city of Cleveland here in the United States, but she's also one of the founding members of Global Cleveland, and she's a true champion for people from our community. Her name is Margaret Wong. She is an incredible woman, a leader, and an attorney, and she is a very dear friend of each and every one of you in the room. Just get to know her. Ladies and gentlemen, Margaret Wong.
I wish I could be closer to you. I don't know why they make us so far away. It's embarrassing. Let me give you some life lessons I've learned. I came to America when I was 19 years old. It's in my book. If you want a free copy, ask one of our people. And I came like us, like people here. I came as a student visa. And in my days, with the Vietnam War, with the, you know, it's just a horrible time. And we don't have money to go back. So now when I hear kids like you, oh, I need a visa to go back to China. I need a visa to go back to Europe to visit my family. I'm like, what? I didn't go home after 3.5 years for 1 week. And then we go home after 3.5 years after we got our green card. It took me 9 years to get my green card. I was fired from like 10 jobs. And finally, to get food on my table, I had to start my own practice. And now we have 9 offices. So I'm just giving you all this to let you know there is hope. There is life in America. This is still the best country in the world, in spite of what Donald Trump is doing to us. I just came in from the Senator Sherrod Brown and Senator Harris from California. They're having a big fundraiser from Subodh Chandra, another good friend of Global Cleveland, and we are all old friends. So here, I noticed the audiences and friends are divided into a few groups. There's some of us who have been here for a long, long time who really cares about people like us. There's some of us who are very, very new, they're foreign students, and you're still trying to analyze what's America all about. Is America what the TV people are saying? Are we that bad, or that good, or that naive, or that stupid, or that smart? There are also those of us who are people of color, who have done it, who have kids your age, and now is the time for us to give back. So let me give you some lessons I've learned in the past. I wish each of you will go out there and make like $500 from my advice, so make your Saturday afternoon worthwhile. My advice is as follows. Number one, read and write and learn. And dare to dream. When I say dream, I don't mean dream about your boyfriend, your girlfriend, you know, who are you gonna marry tomorrow. I'm talking about what you could do to give and take. Unless you give, you don't get. You know what I'm saying? Unless you give, you don't get. On the other hand, unless you ask, you also don't get. When you lose your student visa, keep filing motions and arguments and return it. And you have to fight with them. And another thing is read 3 newspapers a day. Read the Wall Street Journal. I'm learning how Donald Trump and those people think. The only way to learn how they think is to read their newspapers. Rupert Murdoch, how do you think Wendy married him? Exactly, because she worked hard. Good for her. Now she has his blood. She's happily married. She's allegedly slept with all these famous people, Putin, British, to help her. She's also the one that during the Senate testimony, when someone was going to hit an egg or something in her husband, she's the first one to stand up. People like us, everybody here would do it, not just for a husband, for a wife, for our children, for our friends, because we are foreign. We came from a land that's tough and mean. To get that American visa, American people here don't know. You know how we have to stand in line and take crap from them, come through the airports and have to smile and kiss up to them. And in the meantime, they're idiots. They treat us like idiots. They open up. Same with me. Every time I come back from overseas, they open my purse, you know, see, and I say, oh, you're Margaret. Oh, you have so many cases for them. What the hell with you? But in the meantime, I smile. You know, that's how people like us are. So read the New York Times. I love the New York Times, but Wall Street Journal is catching up. Read the Wall Street Journal on Saturdays. It's amazing how the Seth Rupert Murdoch really make it. And read the play theater. It's so important to read your local newspaper. Think small and think big. And network here, pass out your cards. When I was a young lawyer, I went to Westside Journal. I said, I didn't start driving to work until I was in my 40s. I didn't think I've arrived until I was in my 50s. And now my own kids, my young lawyers, they want to be like us. And I tell them, what life is never fair. You need to work hard. So my next advice is develop your core competence. I'm an immigration lawyer. I'm always proud, even though I'm the past president of Federal Bar, I'm a supporter, I give a lot of money to these senators. But in the long run, I am who I am. It doesn't matter how rich you are, how poor you are, develop your core. My core is from my clients. My core is to fight deportation. My core is in the past 6 years, help the Latino people to win cases. In the past 30 years, help the Indians, help the Chinese, help the Filipino get their green cards. And now the children invite me to their weddings, their grandkids are going back home to marry someone. I look at them and say, my gosh, see what we have done. And it's nice when I'm in a taxi, when I'm in an Uber, people say, are you Margaret? I say, yes. They say, oh, you have an age. You got me my green card 20 years ago or 15 years ago. I say, my gosh, look how well they're doing now. You know, it's awesome how our kids are doing. So this is what I want to advise you. Read Black Well-Spoke Outliers. Develop your core. People like you and I, we're not white. We're not rich. We don't have parents and grandparents that own a land, that own a farm, that own a house, that can sell and support us. So develop who we are. If you're an immigration lawyer, do the best you can to help. You always look at what's your constituent of power. I look at Sheriff Brown. In the olden, I've known Sheriff for 40 years. When he was still a state person, he developed his core competence by giving services. Now he developed his core competence by raising money. That's okay too. So you need to look at your core competence. Are you a doctor? Are you a lawyer? Are you an administrator? Are you a politician? It's okay. But be who you are and kiss up to your constituent. My constituent is you. That's why I came today, in spite of hitting another two cars and giving them my business cards, and telling them I'm really sorry to call my office. You know what I'm saying? Because I know I need you. One day someone will need you, and it's good to have love to give. You give and you get. When someone calls you and say, I need some advice from you, don't say, oh, I'm too busy, you know, I need this, I need that. There's always that 2 minutes to give someone. Develop your core. My good friend Dan is here. His core competence is his Cleveland.com web. So, I know, I always get it wrong.
Clevelandpeople.com.
Right, people.com. So, he's here. Why is he here giving up a Sunday, Saturday afternoon? You know what I'm saying? My good friend Robert Smith. He used to work as a plane dealer, and then somewhere else, now with Global Cleveland. His wife is a wonderful musician, also from a foreign country. Why do we all here? Because we want to know you. We want to know how young people think, to help the Facebooks and the Googles. But one day, we will be the next Facebook and Googles and Steve Jobs and all these people. So enjoy, change business cards. There's awesome people in this room. I know a lot of you. So exchange and talk to each other. People like us, we are old and we will be a husband. But people like you are going places. You control the world. And never forget who you are. Thank you. Thanks for coming. I love you all. Thank you.